coming out through the speakers, I presume.
All right.
Rocking with Ill McKenzie right here.
Yo, yo, what it do, world? You are now tuned into the sounds of Quarantine Radio. Yo, what up, world? It's your man 504 Detroit. You already know every Tuesday and every Thursday I'm tuned in to the hottest radio station.
One time for the check-in with my dog, my homie, Ill McKenzie, straight out of ATL, Georgia, and you know how we rocking out here, baby, let's get it.
Once again with another edition of Quarantine Radio. I'm having a couple of technical difficulties, but I'm gonna try to fix that while we are playing some music and everything. Tonight on the show we bring back artist Book T. If you remember on the Blog Talk Radio platform, we had him on the show. He has a new mixtape out. We're gonna get into a little bit of that. See exactly what he's been going through and stuff like that in the independent industry, scene and everything in North Carolina. Other things that we talk about is actually Blog Talk, quarantineenterprise.com. You can go up there because I actually did test it out without even knowing, because what was actually coming through the speakers was the live version of the show and everything. So I got to actually test that out to see exactly what's going on with that and everything. We're going to go to a music break and play a couple of tracks, come back, listen to the actual interview and everything. If you look at the place that you can listen to the show, YouTube, Spreaker.com, CornerEnterprise.com, Facebook Live. Some of y'all probably are looking on Facebook Live right now, watching us. So you can also, if you're going in the car, we have the app, Spreaker.com. You can download the app, Spreaker.com. App on there, look for Quarantine Radio and stuff like that. As always, on the QuarantineEnterprise.com site, as I was telling people before, you can go to, if you're trying to be a sponsor of Quarantine Radio, get your banner put up on the website or behind me. As you see, we have some space behind me, and if you look in front, you'll see you can put some banners back there as well. You have the platinum, gold, silver, and gold, and bronze package. So go up there, you'll see all the different packages and stuff like that. Alright, but we're about to go into a music break and see exactly what's going on with this. But first track that I'm about to play is Zoe Clark with High. We interviewed her a couple years back. Go back on the blog. Oh yeah, that's another thing on QuarantineEnterprise.com. You can actually go to scroll down to the Quarantine Radio site page on there, and you can actually see all my past episodes when I was on Blog Talk Radio too. They're still archived back there, so you can actually look at those too. But this is Zoe Clark with High. Zoe Clark with High. Alright.
Time slips into the future. Ain't getting no younger. Cloud nine every day. The dance floor is waiting. Hands clap, don't hold back. Heart's racing. Look at me, high as a shooter.
they calling me the boogeyman. Boogeyman, 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 boogeyman. I make them on the boogie. Boogie, 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 boogie. I'm the boogeyman. Boogeyman, 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 boogeyman. I make them on the boogie. Boogie, boogie, boogie. Another story about Lucci, just like a movie. I swear my life is like a movie, just kinda spooky. My girl a rider like I'm Lucius, I call her Cookie. She'll put the burner in a bitch before they book me. You niggas acting like you know me, you never knew me. My nigga in the low, that was my ace, that was my boogie. He taught me all about the game, I was a rookie. I think he turned me to a monster, it's getting spooky. And yeah, now they calling me the boogeyman. Boogeyman, 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 boogeyman. Cause gangsters want a boogie. Boogie, 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 boogie. I'm the boogeyman. Boogeyman, 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 boogeyman. Never met me. I'm on the beach drinking Coronas, El Presidente. I got a friend named Ramona. She call me Jefe. She call me Poppy, call me Chulo. I give her leche. You know you like it, but you hate it. Got it respected. You know my goons is out there banging. You get the message. When we pull it, we make them boogie. You learn a lesson. I'm in Miami smoking cookie. I'm never stressing. I'm in the lows, I'm in the palms. I'm in the seven. Series Beamer with the top off, looking at heaven. I'm in the club, I'm in the VIP. We making movies, popping bottles and popping ish and fucking groupies. Because they know that I'm the boogeyman. Boogeyman, 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 boogeyman. Cause gangsters want a boogie. Boogie, 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 boogie. I'm the boogeyman.
I'm proper. That Madison J, ain't come from the hood. I stroll through the R. I holla at Petey, holla at two, holla at Kizzy. I know she gon' probably be mixed with the crew. Holla at Shice, holla at Black, holla at News, holla at Mez, holla at Rome, nigga, we own, yeah. Holla at Ola, holla at Mills, who chasing that check, ain't for the neck. Applying the pressures, I only do best. I'm rocking with Pooh, I holla at Ruger, I'm raising the bar. Got love for the city. Hey, this be the all, this who we are, yes!
I've been waiting for my day to come, so now I feel it's my time to shine. I've been waiting for my day to come, so now I feel it's my time to shine, yeah. We ready, yeah, we ready, yeah, we ready. Who was who said that we won, yeah? We ready, yeah, we ready, yeah, we ready. Who was who said that we won, yeah?
Feel like the throne, feel like I'm home. Into my zone, I usher him in. But we ain't got time for lovers and friends. Immaculate pen.
If they pull it out, I might detonate. Rap crowds, I separate. Gotta stay around from these f***ing fakes. I legendary, and this is just the debut. Labels try to enslave you. I'm so in tune with the matrix. Took it back to the basics. Mingled with all the races. Take my name elevated. This week is called elevation. Okay, everything's cool. Just watch how you move. When we enter the groove, whatever you choose. You shoot for the stars, then you aiming to lose. Hey, I done waited 20-something odd years for this. Counting for life. That explains why I kill for this. Yes!
I've been waiting for my day to come. So now I feel it's my time to shine. I've been waiting for my day to come. So now I feel it's my time to shine. Yeah. We ready. Yeah. We ready. Yeah. We ready. For the ones who said that we won. Yeah. We ready. Yeah. We ready. Yeah. We ready. For the ones who said that we won. Yeah.
Time to come up. Show to our world why I'm next for the crown. Gave you the tapes. I just been working. The master of the sound, master of the craft. You would've thought I was plotting with masons. Growing impatient. Thinking the minutes and seconds I wasted. The practice is ancient. Started my day with the waking and baking. Hey, here go the flow. Hey, give me your ears and even exchange. Oh Lord, I hope I don't fall from this game. I'm trying, I'm trying, I'm trying to make my way. Salute to my fam. I am what I am. You encourage the man. I hatching a plan. We letting a fool. Got glue on hands. They ain't get it. I push the limit. Sick of with it. Pictures I orchestrated, illustrated. Hope you get it, yes!
I've been waiting for my day to come. So now I feel it's my time to shine. I've been waiting for my day to come. So now I feel it's my time to shine. Yeah, we ready. Yeah, we ready. Yeah, we ready. For the ones who said that we won. Yeah, we ready. Yeah, we ready. Yeah, we ready. For the ones who said that we won.
Yes.
They fed me to the wolves, but I'ma lead the pack. I caught the hater, intercept, now watch me run it back. Run it back. Saving music like... But what's the fun in that? It ain't no competition. They get bit and they don't really rap. No. Yeah. What's the fun in that? All they wanna do is hit the clubs up. Trap. Papa Molly, parents asking where their son is at. I don't stop to notice cause I'm aiming where the sun is at. I'm shooting higher than the next chick. Did they whole day's worth of work before my breakfast? Until my money gets long, my days get hectic. I ain't did enough, so I feel my dreams neglected. A workaholic, I just call it what I built for. They only made one me, they like go build more. And even then, they wouldn't really feel raw. Venomous a beast, what the f*** you think she killed for? Vision, vision, vision. Always having vision, having vision. I'm having dreams of making it. And if I could, I would wake up with my eyes closed. So I know that still be there. And you'll be there. And you'll be there. But don't wake me up. They either love you or hate you today, don't they? I'm just trying to make these moves until they want me like Chipotle. Visions living, getting really, yeah, they feel her, do they hear her? I'm just cooking up these bars and I distribute through the dealers. Copyright infringement, how they copy what I'm giving. I'm just talking what I witness. You should talk less and go listen. Wanna know why am I distant? I'm just trying to go the distance. And not everyone can come, so I'm just asking for forgiveness. And it sure don't come easy though. You know the saying, how it's easy come, easy go. My life a movie, can't wait for the sequel though. The way I'm leading, like I'm about to let my people go. A legend heading for the top of all the billboards. They only made one me, they like go build more. And even then they wouldn't even feel more. I always be a beast, what the f*** you think I kill for? Yeah, vision,
vision. Vision.
Always having vision.
Having vision. Having vision.
That's all we got is vision.
Vision. Vision.
Yeah. I'm having dreams of making it. And if I could, I would wake up with my eyes closed. So I know that still be there.
venomous. You know.
In this life, dreams give us hope. If you follow them, you can achieve them. If you fall down, may God help you find that place of restoration. Dust yourself off and continue on. Life is a dream. Within a dream.
I see my dreams coming through daily. Forget about the haters. No, life gets weighty and people get shady. I move past the clouds. I feel my passion now. If you believe it, then go and just act it out. No backing down, I gotta pray fearless. Master my craft, trying to stay peerless. Even though they call us the weirdest, spitting on our dreams. I got an audience of one, playing fiddles for the king. Started dreaming like Joseph, make my brothers explosive. Telling me I'm in sin, I'm prideful and boasting. But I'm hyped with this rapid eye movement, let's get to it. Who said destiny have to flow fluid? I'm a student of the word, obedient to his voice. And every time I'm rapping, I'm mapping it on the course. All these dreams making me rejoice. Cause one day I'm gonna see them in full force.
You can rain on my parade, but you'll never stop these dreams of mine. These dreams of mine. Cause I know why I was made.
I was made
to magnify the king on high. The king on high.
Yeah, if I ever had the chance, would I go back? Back on the field with a glove and a smooth bat. My eyes open wide, take a full swing. Little Reem at the plate, tried to do his thing. I got a little better, had to work real hard. Long walks to the park, Sanford Boulevard. It was all a dream, couldn't see nothing else. All-star, city champs, trophies on the shelf. Mount Vernon was the place, you could say the Vern. When my life came through, waiting on my turn. But if the truth be told, I'm feeling real weak. Passion running out of fuel and I can't speak. Holy Spirit, plug me up, need a little charge. Purpose can't hit the road, sitting in garage. God help me turn the page in this life story. Whatever comes my way, you getting all the glory.
You can rain on my parade, but you'll never stop these dreams of mine. These dreams of mine. Cause I know why I was made.
I let my pants sag. Back in junior high, before most of us white guys hopped on the bandwagon. Before we were ever considered on par amongst rappers, I was a star in my own thoughts, nothing but aspirations. To spit in the phrases written on pages, on the biggest of stages. Not for me, but uplifting the savior.
That's right.
The chicken scratch from a pencil and pad showed I was itching to match the sounds from the founders of Christian rap. But then I slipped omitting my naps. Till the end of the 90s, heard Jada kissing Eminem rap. And right around then, cross movement was hitting the map. And that's when I came to equip with a renewed vision to rap. And realize somebody get tapped into my mental, like Inception. Grab my dreams and shoplifting. So link with some dudes who shared the same vision. Now we're living in a state where our totems never stop spinning.
You can rain on my parade.
Let it rain.
Let it rain. But you never stop these dreams of mine. These dreams of mine. Cause I know why I was made.
Now I'm f***ing up the commas. Let's enjoy the come up.
York Street, baby, move the gatewood to Boone Road. No matter where I be, South Raleigh's where I go. City to city, state to state, execute my plate. Scraping my plate for my family, just another day. Out here getting paper and plenty assets. Can't enjoy the cash yet till I get to have that $1 billion man dream. Make it reality divine. Ain't no life quite like mine. How I grind, be my own biz. Out here on some real. Keep your comments to yourself, lest you wanna hear truth that I speak daily on these Raleigh streets. Some niggas big time and acting like they molded me. From where I'm at, sit on the coldest seat. You never see me move, but my moves got you on that potent heat. Feel that fire from a G who done peep game. Time for my reign, all this pain that I overcame. Book came from the bottom, Thomas to the E. You try to front on me, you lied, come on. And now I'm f***ing up the comments, Thomas. Jones, TJ Jones, you know who it be. I got G's off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. Moving P's off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. She say she wanna meet me off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. That's where I be low key off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. I came from the bottom. Try to front on me, you lie. And now I'm up the comments. Let's enjoy the comma. I got G's off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. Moving P's off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. She say she wanna meet me off of exit 300, 100, 100, 100. That's where I be low key off of exit 300, 100. 100, 100.
Last track was our guest tonight, Book T, Exit 300. We're going to talk about his project, Exit 300, and everything. I'm gonna, for those that didn't listen to him when we were on Blog Talk Radio, I'm going to give him like an opportunity to give an insight of who he is and what he's about before we jump into this interview. All right?
Hey, I guess this is my time to talk. Man, basically, dog, at the end of the day, I am a leader of a generation just bringing about positive enlightenment. I'm just doing my thing, man. I'm realizing progressive thoughts in my head and actually making them realization. So in my particular definition of success, man, I just continue to just live life each day and try to get this creative ability out of me. As you see, I come in with a highly educated brand. That's the way of life. That's, you know, highly educated everything. It's on my glasses even. You know, it's on my shirt. Hell, man, we might even put that on some drawers one day. You know what I'm talking about? But, man, this is all highly educated, man. It's all God-given. It's all about knowing yourself and knowing your way in life. And so that you can truly apply yourself to be able to not only help yourself, but help others. So as far as the music goes, the music's always been a part of me since I was a teenager. If anybody that went to school with me, they know that's what I did. I did music. I was a journalist, so I went to school for communications and broadcasting, got a master's degree in entertainment business. So just public speaking was always my thing, president of my class and all that type of good stuff, man. And I just been able to have the ability to express myself through rhyme and rhythm for quite some time. And I'm thankful to God that I got a good team on my shoulder and I'm actually healthy enough to be able to give that music and that expression to the people.
Okay. Since the last time that we had you on the show and everything, I kind of hear the development of your rap and everything and stuff like that. And you building up your brand, got the clothing line and stuff like that. And like you said, you went to school for business and everything. And that's very important. Like as far as advice to independent artists and everything about like that's one thing like a lot of independent artists don't understand. Once you step into this field and this business, you are a brand.
Absolutely.
You are a business. You own your own business. That's kind of like what Jay-Z says, I'm a business
Yeah.
What is your actual independent artists like developing and putting a stamp on who they are as artists to actually brand out and keep this shit talking about?
My advice is actually that. Put a stamp on who you are. Monetize who you are. Stop listening or watching things and putting on a mask as though it's Halloween coming on, trying to pretend that you're that character, hoping that, you know, maybe hope will float me toward a destiny or some dream instead of actually, you know, doing the research or actually having the experience to put forth the hard work. You got to get outside of the likes. You got to get outside of the follows. You got to get outside of all that stuff and really recognize, you know, the true nature of the business that you're in. Because at the end of the day, none of that really means nothing. You know, if people aren't voting for you with their dollar or with their time, at the end of the day, your grind doesn't mean anything. So I would tell a lot of independent artists, you know, continue to pursue their craft. Do not stop it, not one bit, but be realistic about it. And when it's time to put your money where your mouth is in order to invest in your craft, invest and stop BSing about it. Don't try to sugarfoot or try to dance around the issue in terms of, hey, man, I might have to put some money up in order to make some things happen for me. You need to do it. You know, stop being afraid. So I think that's the main thing I would tell, man. Stop being afraid. Scared money don't make money. And scared dreams don't make realities.
True. That's one thing that a lot of people don't understand. They're like, they have to invest into their craft. Like, any business that you get into, you have to invest in that. And, like, most businesses, you don't see revenue in probably, like, 2 to 3 years within.
Absolutely.
Like, that's where a lot of artists is, they get discouraged and stuff like that because they're not making money right away. And, like, I understand, like, a lot of people, like, they got to eat and stuff like that. But, like, if you really passionate about this, like, you got to put money on it.
You got to. You got people that have 9-to-5s. You got people that have 5-to-9s. Whatever it is, but I mean, it's not costing a lot of money to invest in yourself. At the end of the day, you got independent artists that would rather seek shows where, you know, hey, I can go in and perform for free, rather than realizing, hey, you're gonna perform for free at this show, or and invite everybody to pay $5 to get in, but you're not gonna get a cut of that. So if you got 20, 30, 40 followers in your neighborhood that all listen to your music, why not put out your own show? Why not do your own thing? Why? Because you're scared to invest in yourself? Because you're spending that extra $100, $200, $300 on what you don't need to be spending it on? Why not put that into your actual craft? So that it's not a thing where this craft is actually breaking anybody. Nobody's breaking the bank. But you can obviously go bigger with a bigger budget. But it's not going to take a lot of your time and a lot of your budget in order to truly pursue your dreams step by step by step.
And you mentioned something. You mentioned two things that I want to actually touch on. Well, the last thing that you actually mentioned about budgets and stuff like that. Like I said, like when you enter this business, you become a business and stuff like that.
Correct.
And like a lot of people, like they don't like set their budget as far as like whether or not you decide to get a manager or a PR and stuff like that. Like, what is your thoughts on like actually a rapper actually sitting down and like chopping up like how they could promote themselves? And like you said something about actually studying the craft and everything, stuff like that. Like, what are your thoughts on that as far as them actually sitting down and realizing what they're going to have to do and how mathematically what they're going to make and what they're going to have to put in?
Well, first and foremost, management and PR, for me, actually sounds crazy. I've never had a manager. No, I've been a manager, but I've never had a manager. Not is it that I didn't want one. Please, I've been on my knees. Lord knows I've been asking for a manager or somebody to help me out with some of this. But at the end of the day, you got to realize, man, you got to take the realization of the thought that you have in your head and realize you can't walk around with worry. And you can't walk around with people wanting to come around you in order to do something for you for free. So I guess at the end of the day, you have to take hold of your own dreams. I sat in rooms and itemized my budget for this, for that, what I wanted to spend it on, how I wanted to do it, how I wanted it to look. And if there was people that I wanted to gauge the ideas off or, you know, just to bounce some different flow off of it just to see was I thinking correctly, I executed that, okay? Maybe pick 10 people just to ask how this looked. They don't even know that they're part of my 10 people list. They could be coworkers, they could be family members, whatever. But it all coincides with me making an executive decision on where to go with that particular detail. Say, for instance, if it's an album cover, you can have the same process. Okay, I made this album cover, but I got a couple different ones. I need to help myself make a decision on it. Make a decision, but ultimately trust your gut. Let others give input, but ultimately trust your gut when it comes to your dreams. And sit down and actually think about it. Put some thought into it, because you can't just impulse everything. And I think that's what really, really needs to happen, is that people need to realize that that thought is the progressive reality that you're making. So if you're keeping your thoughts in worry, you're keeping your thoughts boxed and afraid, and keeping your thoughts thinking that you're the realest dude in the room and all that other craziest nonsense, then that's what you're going to get. But if you keep your thoughts fixated on your goal and what you're really trying to accomplish, hey, man, things are going to continue to stack up day by day by day. You got to conquer that day in order to get to the next one. So, just don't stop and continue to keep your mind right first. Get your mind right and stay highly educated. You know what I'm talking about?
You almost mentioned something else that I wanted to actually touch on as well. You actually talked about the visual as far as the artwork on the album cover and everything. Like, there was a lot of independent artists upset with Kendrick Lamar. He dropped his album in it with just his face with this.
Yeah.
Font,
yeah.
And it was like, it was so, if an independent artist like did that, they probably get no love and stuff like that. But it was simple, but it's still adapted to his personality and stuff like that. And like that's another thing, like when you think about like your visual, like you have to adapt to your personality, and that's what a lot of people are incorporating. Feel like they trying to translate the word I'm trying to think of right there. They feel more close to you and stuff like that, especially like if you put something that hits their mind and stuff.
Right. Well, the main thing is keep it simple. So I applaud him for keeping it simple. And with Kendrick's particular stance, you know, he has the ability to and still sustain a fan base. So I do get where an independent artist may say, hey, man, this dude can just put out anything, you know, and people will go buy it just because he's got that platform. Absolutely, he earned that platform. He got there. All right, so we ain't gonna recognize that, so we ain't gonna hate on that. But as an independent artist, you need to say, hey, you know, I got the same ability to keep it simple with myself. It doesn't mean that what you're putting out is any worse or any better, but it does mean that it's yours. It does mean that it's independent. It does mean it's of your mind. Again, it goes back to just stop seeing things and trying to recreate what you've already seen. Try to be authentic and try to be original. And in doing that, you'll be able to see and recognize it's such simple things about yourself that the world could grasp onto. Hey, man, you might be anime dude? You might be an anime dude. You don't even know it. You watch anime every night, but you're a dope rapper. So why not? But that's a particular part of your character. You can take that and flip that on your record, and people could catch that. It's just keeping it simple about your character. So in terms of that particular album with Kendrick's character at that moment, for what he was going through and what he was trying to portray on that album, it was more so of a damn. You know what I mean? Because that's what we're facing here. You know, it's a situation that when we take a look at the intellect of each other as a people, you know, look at our country, man. It does make you sometimes take a four-letter word and shake your head and say, damn. So just keeping it simple, man. Just keeping it simple. With me, man, book T, Knowledge Before Self. Highly educated. It took me to scribbling down some paper, coming up with an idea to create, and a Rubik's Cube or a map of my city, Exit 300. So you just got to keep it simple with yourself.
True, true, true. And the other thing that you mentioned is, like, you're the second person to actually mention this on the show in the past 2 weeks about artists actually going out there and networking with venues and stuff like that, putting on your own show and stuff like that. You get a couple of artists and get them to pay to perform and stuff like that. You make your own money and stuff like that, and plus you build your own brand, getting your target audience and stuff like that. Like, what moves did you actually make to actually be able to network with these venues and stuff like that?
I made some solid moves with relationships, building relationships with people that had relationships with venues that I was able to confront them on, and that were able to play middleman in some cases. I also did meet a lot of different venues and different different producers or different people that can help advance my career in a lot of different areas, and realize that building those bridges were most important instead of burning them. You get into a lot of situations where people can feel like they're molding who you are, or they feel like they're responsible for where you're going, or they're the gatekeepers, and you don't really deal with those people, man. Like, no matter how high or how low they are, sometimes there are people that are right there in your face that you know that you're the blessing for them, but they're so high and mighty at the time that they don't even recognize, you know, what God has in place for you, place for them at the moment. And at that point, you probably feel like you're an angel, but don't feel too high and mighty. That just means you recognize you're in tune with the universe. So at the end of the day, I would say only mess with the people that really work well with you. It doesn't mean that you guys have to always agree. No, not at all. But there are people that have an intricate love for you, what you do, who you are as a person. Maybe it's your music. Maybe it's your grind. Maybe they're attracted to you. But only work with those that want to work with some level of your character, of who you are. Anybody that's detracting from that, they're not a part of the solution. They're a part of the problem in your life. And it ain't like, as a black man, I ain't got enough of those. I was just in the hospital weeks ago for stress and crazy stuff. So I got enough of problems and worry and stuff in my life. So moving forward, that was part of the process, is just building relationships that were going to apply solutions in my life, instead of provide problems.
True. Like, you mentioned something that I actually incorporate in my daily life as well. Because, like, there are times that a lot of people, like, they want to burn bridges and stuff like that. And, like, I always talk about this a little while. I think it was the last episode. With the 6 degrees of separation.
Yeah.
And everything. You know about 6 degrees of separation?
I know about the movie. Will Smith was pretty gay in that one.
Yeah,
it's a good movie, though.
Yeah, the situation is that you're one person away from getting to the person that you need to meet.
Absolutely, the concept. Yeah.
So, it's cause, like, there was one venue that I was working on, because, like, I was doing the speed dating and kind of stepped back from that, but there was one venue that I was actually going to work with, and guy that I was talking to, when I went back and I was ready and everything, all of a sudden that guy no longer worked there and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And they upped the price.
Come on.
So, like, I was like, maybe this ain't for me right now. Because, like, my other friend was like, you need to continue with this and stuff, like, you'll keep building brand and stuff like that. Well, because, like, that event, like, I looked at it as a failure, but a lot of people didn't. Like, I had, like, 25 to 30 girls there and no guys.
Wow. Yeah, it was a good night for you, though.
Well, I was only at the speed date. I'm kidding. Personally, I felt bad because these girls came here to speed date and there were no guys. But, like, I had speakers. Last enough person was telling me, well, at least you had a backup plan. But, like, I had speakers that could educate them on relationships and stuff like that. So, like, because, like, in the back of my mind, like, the whole thing was that if they didn't come away with a date, they were educated on everything.
Exactly.
But as far as the progress from your last mixtape to now you're trying to go into an album and stuff like that, what made you on the concept to say that I'm not going to put out a mixtape, I'm going to drop an album?
Well, man, Ill McKenzie, it's been about a year and a half since my last project, which was Kickback Tracks. And at that time, I was going through, you know, a phase in my life where I had just had a newborn baby. And I found myself being, you know, a stay-at-home dad. It's not too many of us that look like this to get the opportunity to be stay-at-home dads. And so I raised my daughter for about a good year and a half for the most part. And in doing that, you know, I was just reflecting and realizing that I was past that part of my life where, you know, it was time to truly start to invest more into what I already have, what I've accomplished, and stop trying to. Sometimes you have sectors of your life and people that, you know, are that you really, really look up to. But the people that you look up to sometimes haven't accomplished half of what you've accomplished. You just really want them to really like you and get vindication from them that you're good. And once I realized, and through that Kickback Track phase, when I was with my daughter doing a lot of reflecting, I realized that's kind of what I was doing in a lot of my life, just trying to get acceptance from people that were rappers or were producers or doing this like me. And I'm out here dope, man. I can produce. I engineer my own records. I rap. I sing. Whatever, man. I've done a lot of stuff. And it's not even about that. It's not even about the ego. It's about I had to set aside my ego to realize all these positive things about me before I realized, like, hey, I just want to do this to please this guy that's in my this or this girl that's in my life just to say I'm good, and they want to hear it all day long. And once I woke up out of that funk that I was in and, put a lot of the things that I was drinking and stuff down, I was able to realize that, I had something special. Not only that I had something special, I was speaking to people, and people were realizing that I was able to, I was applying change in their life for the better. And that made me stronger. So the strength from my supporters is what made me bring about an album. And realize that, hey, I can't continue to just, not that the music wasn't good for the mixtapes I was putting out, but it's just I can't continue to not give my supporters the best, like, of me as a whole. Because obviously on the mixtape, some of those beats aren't mine, and I'm going to other studios to record. And I figured I'd give them something to where, hey, this was just all from my brain. This was all from me at my house, doing my thing, on my dime, on my own time, from me to you. And in that reflective process, man, I just felt like coming up with that and actually giving my supporters an opportunity to vote for me, not with a like, but with actually sharing a stake in my process and in my dream and in my accomplishments.
Okay, and with the title, Exit 300.
Should know.
What made you decide to go with that title for your album?
Exit 300 is who I am. Exit 300 is me. I am Exit 300 from each side of the bridge. Southeast Raleigh baby all day long. I am a Southeast Raleigh graduate. I also went to different various schools and was kept by different various people off Exit 300, friends, family, you name it. That embodies my culture. Southside. I'm the Southside ambassador, whatever the heck you want to call this. I can articulate where I come from to a degree where, unfortunately, a lot of my other fellow brothers don't have that same articulate process. Not to mean that they can't accomplish that and they're not with that, but normally the stereotype of the South Side is that most brothers ain't coming out there articulating and graduating with 2 degrees and all the other crazy stuff. But I was able to accomplish those things amidst whatever the stereotypes were in that particular environment. Even now, the South Side dealing with a lot of gentrification. So real estate is good if you got the money, you want to buy some houses. But that definitely means people that look like myself is getting carried out. I was there to see Exit 300 thrive and see it grow into what it is today. And what made me call it Exit 300 is whether I went to college, whether I was in Los Angeles, whether I was in Washington, D.C., whenever I came home, I always came home to somewhere off of Exit 300. And whether that was Gatewood, whether that was Southgate, whether that was off Poole Road, whether it was Cook Street, Jones Street, Lane Street, all over that area, man, I was always in that area. This was an album that encompassed my life, something I can give back to the hood, something I can give back to that part of me. And again, give my supporters a stake in my reality and where I'm going with my life.
Okay.
Originally, it was called Poppin' the Hood, but Exit 300, accomplished everything that I wanted to pop in the hood to accomplish and more. Poppin' the Hood in Exit 300 are kind of about the same thing, the graduation and the maturity of me going from a boy to a man.
So what made you change
that? Just... honestly, spending a lot of time off Exit 300, spending a lot of time, man, off of it and realizing that, that as I was creating to make more music, because originally I just started with a single, I was going to play the single game, like, hey, we'll see how a single go, keep it going with my fan base. And the single was going pretty good, but I continued to make more and more music. My computer's already filled with enough music right now, man, that's off the chain. I still got to get it out to you. And where I was... is I was encompassing more of that sound of where that Exit 300 sound, that South Side, that grunge, that hunger. And man, as I continued to write, continue to rap, I realized, you know, 20 songs later, you know, hey man, I really have something here. And that's what, and it's bigger than Pop in the Hood. It encompasses more than just me making that particular change from a boy to a man. So it was more than just Pop in the Hood. It was more than just doing that. It was actually giving the people a chance to actually see how they've inspired me and how I've been able to grow in spite of it.
So it was basically a growth.
Yeah.
That you wanted to embody and show everybody.
Yep.
You mentioned that you have a lot of music and stuff like that. What process did you go through to actually pick which songs were actually going to be on the album and everything? Did you have like a listening party and have people listen to it and say, yeah, this is a hit? Or did you just go about your own line trying to say, this is what I'm going to put on there?
Nah, man. I didn't have a listening party, but I definitely got an album release party coming up this weekend, this Saturday. Make sure you in the building, dog. it's at Motion Lounge. But nah, what it was is it was my team. It was me, my brothers. I got two great brothers that come into the studio, sometimes together, sometimes separately, and they'll sit down with me. Sometimes we'll ride out, take trips, whatever. And a lot of my songs that I run with a lot of times are their favorites. And this particular album that I've encompassed at one point was always that track, that new track that I did that was the favorite for like a good 2 weeks. It was the best track I had on my whole computer. Each one of those 10 tracks, 12 tracks at each time was that one newest track that I kept playing over and over again. And it was also the track that my brothers would come along and they would have the same feeling. You know, like, man, that new one, 2 weeks later, they come by, I ain't seen them in a while. Hey, man, I got something new for you. Oh, man, that one right there, though. And it's just each one continued to snowball into that. Now, once I had a lot of them, once, like I said, I was about 20 records deep, in terms of narrowing those down, that was a matter of the concept, like, of which songs tell the story, which songs from front to back reach out to the soul of the listener and connect with that listener in a way that I'm actually truly trying to convey with the album. And so you get some songs where they're really great songs, but they don't fit with the direction of the album you're going in with this particular time. And I had some of those. And that, you know, it's not a hard process, but it just takes a moment to continue to truly try to listen to it and make sure that you're actually encompassing the same emotion that the listeners are getting from it as well. So, I mean, from front to back, Exit 300 gave me that growth feeling, and you know that's when I knew I really had something there.
Okay. We're actually going to go into a music break. We'll come back, talk more about you, your clothing line and stuff like that, and basically like everything, your growth and everything. Like there's nothing I wanted to ask you about, but like I did see you DJing and everything.
Yeah,
and
man.
Like that, so I wanted.
I got eight jobs, man.
I
want
to pick your brain about that as well. But the first track that I'm about to play is Lebo with Party. It's Lebo with Party.
Want me now. Take her to the crib, panda coming down. Love boy, hunt around. flow where need 100 times. Bet it ain't even got 100 miles. Either like she got 100 miles. Make a wanna have 100 child. Switch the flow up, got 100 style. Better play this the whole summertime. We gon' have a party, smoking bottle popping. This my type of party. Lobby full of Barbies and they say they wanna party. Party. She just know the ropes. That ain't my type of party. But what you do on, I get you invited to the party. Lobby full of Barbies and they say they want a party. We gon' have a party.
PS1 diamonds in my chain. Got it all off the Mary Jane. Mary Jane, she bought me everything. Turn your party up, I do my thing.
And they poppin' people, my don't chill, they just poppin' seal. Winning the years and they poppin' still. No Instagram stuntin', they poppin' for real. Lubo, you leanin', I'm probably ill. If you only knew how this knot is feel. It just knotted a rock for real. Somebody give me a doctor in here. Interstate, this look the fault in here. Hold on, nobody get naughty in here. Interstate, this look the fault in here. Hold on, nobody get naughty in here. Cause they gon' get they clouded in here. And they gon' get them life out of some here. Play if you wanna, you know what it is. Handful of n***a, but all of them real. Knit full of diamonds and all of them real. Reefer my diamond, that's how you get killed. I said, reefer my diamond, that's how you get killed. Please do not fuck up the party for real.
Tomorrow,
we gon' have a party. Smoking bottle popping. This my type of party. Lobby full of Barbies and they say they want a party. We gon' have a party. She just know the ropes. That ain't my type of party. But what you do on, I get you invited to the party. Lobby full of Barbies and they say they want a party. We gon' have a party.
Making noise, all this clap, gotta keep it moving. Oh,
That's why they mad, cause we winning and they losing. The love so fake, but the hate so real. I'm on my zero, of giving so of how you feel. I don't fuck around with you, fuck around, cause them fuck around to get you killed. You can ask around and see how it sounds, but I'm giving you shit with no chill. I'm giving you precision, my view, just loving my sex appeal. Loving the game that I be spitting constantly, wrecking this thing in the tear. I go crazy, I go dummy, hit you with that, ain't I lovely? I ain't trying to fall in love, I'm at your neck about my money. Money on my mind, better get it right. I'm on the grind, morning, noon, day and night. Night, better get it right. Pull up, let it rip like
old shots.
Money on my mind, better get it right. I'm on the grind, morning, noon, day and night. Night, better get it right. Pull up, let it rip like on sight.
Get it.
You taste of my love. If I wanna drop it, boy, will you pick it back up? I can be a lover, I can be a best friend. I'm a little danger. Tell me, can you handle this? Give me a reason to let you taste up on my love. If we take it slow, can we switch beat the beat back up?
Too much, babe.
me that you feel the same. Now it's just the two of us.
Ooh.
If you want it, make it yours. This could be a work of art. Boy, you gotta play your part. I don't wanna fall so hard. But if you wanna let you hold my heart, do what you wanna do. It's all up to you.
I should be your number one, number one, number one.
I
should be your number one girl. I should be your number one girl.
I should be your number one. I should be your number one
girl.
I should be your number one
girl.
I won't stop until I get enough. I'm so thankful that I found your love. And baby, you got all of my trust. Yeah. I won't stop until I get enough. I'm so thankful that I found your love. And baby, you got all of my trust. Yeah.
I should be your number one. I should be your number one.
I should be your number one.
I should be your number one.
Got the light.
the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods.
Back in the
woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood.
Popping the hood.
This what this feel like on a mission. See plenty, penny pitch. My hustle and muscle untangled the tussle, the noose, so many wishing. They don't want to see another me hang for a couple keys. Giving up integrity for more fame. Smoke about an ounce, no brain. Can't let you down when ain't no shame. And dresses looking all sweet. Talk about booty, what y'all eat. Just can't stand up on they feet. Too busy laying on they back. Waiting for change, I'm changing the lane. With the fattest on my chain. Rubbing me down to where I came. With a G, no need. Make my dollar pop my collar. Where I lead it, y'all just follow. She giving me death, both this side of
feel like I'm back in the woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods. Rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood. Feel like I'm back in the woods,
back in the
woods. Rolling the goose, she all on my chest. I'm popping the hood,
popping the hood.
Most niggas really ain't feminized and criminalized. And watch out who you wanna hang with. You telling truth, they telling lies. Most niggas really ain't feminized and criminalized. Better watch out who you wanna hang with. You telling truth, they telling lies.
Shout out my Max Steel for bringing me this beat in 2016. Said Book T, I know you the man to go ahead and make this hot. Go ahead and bring the hook man on it, and let's go ahead and make something happen. You know what, Max Steel? You're right, man. So I went ahead and put that paper, put the pen to work, and I ain't waste time, man. And I want to appreciate South Raleigh's finest for staying together and go ahead and do their thing. And I hope this highly educated thing continue to influence y'all to use y'all brain. You know who it
feel like I'm back in the woods, rolling the goose. She all on my chest, I'm popping the hood.
Popping the hood.
Feel like I'm back in the woods,
back in the
rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood,
popping the hood.
Feel like I'm back in the woods,
back in the
rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood,
popping the hood.
Feel like I'm back in the woods,
back in the
rolling the goose. She all on my chest. I'm popping the hood.
You got 10 games right?
Yeah.
Man, when I need an extra dollar, I'm about to hit you up on the line.
But, yeah, but I'm still, let me see what all.
That's good.
Place that you have in there. Okay. No, James is in the lead. So, yeah. I ain't going to get into that. But I'm only two points behind you. So, if James is listening, like I said, we're going to work on actually getting the phone system and everything so we can get James to call in. If y'all remember back in Block Talk, me and James is always talking drunk and everything about sports and everything. If you're on the sports, liquor, and stats group, you actually see that as well. But, right now he has 62 points. I have 60. So I just need to come up with some upsets this week and hope he doesn't pick those upsets and everything. But let me go over my picks for this week and everything, and then we're going to jump back into the interview. This thing loads up correctly, so I can do that. Okay, there we go. All right, Thursday night game is Miami and the Ravens. I'm going to go with the Ravens over the Dolphins. If Vikings and the Browns. I'm going to go with the Vikings over the Browns. Falcons and the Jets. I'm trying to decide if I want to put that as an upset. Because the Jets got a defense. No, I'm going to go with the safety. Falcons over the Jets. I'm going to go with the... I'm going to go with the Bills over the Raiders. Saints over the Bears. Go with the Bengals over the Colts. I'm going to go with this upset as well. Chargers over the Patriots. I'm going to go with the Eagles over the 49ers. Because my Buccaneers, I don't want to do this, even though I don't want to do this, I'm going to go with the Panthers over my Buccaneers.
You know what?
Just because there's some kings that they're still working out and everything. That's one thing about being in Carolina, I've got to get with these Panthers fans. I really want to go with the Buccaneers, but like Coach Ryan said on ESPN, they're not living up to expectations this year. But we'll talk about that later. Another upset. I'm going to go with the Texans over the Seahawks. I'm going to go with the Cowboys over the Redskins. Let's see if I'm going to do this upset or not. I'm going to go with the Lions. I'm going to go with the Lions over the Steelers. It seems like we're going to
There's at least three of those games where it's just like, come on, really? You're reaching.
And go to the Chiefs over the Broncos. Both of them got killer defense and everything, so that's going to be a good Monday night match.
That's a good one.
Broncos got to work out some kinks with their offense and everything, but both the Chiefs and the Broncos got killer. So that one can go either way, actually. But, yeah, they're going to be in Kansas City, so I'm going to go with the Chiefs over the Broncos on that one. We might swing back around and talk about this.
Oh, man, I love to.
You had some facial expressions.
Man, you had some suspect picks there.
Like I said, I got it. Like, Jane's been getting on me ever since we started this and everything. Like, there was one year that I we can go back into the podcast and everything. Like, he won't admit to it, but, like I almost beat him one year, and I forgot to make my picks one week. And it was the last week, and he ran away with it.
Oh, come on now.
He won't admit to it. He won't, because he talked about...
You sure you forgot? Yeah. Oh, you sure?
I my picks. Like, it was Sunday, I woke up, and by the end of the night, he was telling me how he was beating me, and I was like, dang, I forgot to make my picks.
You went 16 weeks picking your picks, and you forgot on the last week?
Yeah.
Nah, McKenzie, I ain't believing it, bro. I wouldn't let you live that down either.
He has beat me every year. And then we invited more people to come along and stuff like that to join in. So, next year, if you want to match up with us, I'll tag you, let you know.
Keep me in the loop, man. I'm down.
But we're going to go back into the interview and everything, talk more about your brand and everything. I want to talk about the DJ and everything. Like, I actually saw that and everything. Like, that's kind of a genius thing. You're being an artist. You get to go out there and spin your own music and everything. Well, what made you decide to get into the DJing?
Spinning my own music. That was it, man. You know what? You understand how hard it is to get respect from anybody in Raleigh to play your music? Because it seemed like, obviously, everybody in the world want to be a rapper. And, you know, then also that coming from the background that I come from, I'm not coming with a whole bunch of rah-rah and, yo, man, I'm going to give you a 20 bag to play my song, all type of crazy stuff. Yeah. I'm coming with a lot of professionalism to a lot of people that can really help me in my career. But as I said earlier, a lot of people feel like they're the gateway. So if you're not coming to them with what they expect of you at the moment, then a lot of times they're not really trying to hear you. It doesn't mean you're a good artist. It doesn't mean you're a bad artist. It just means they're looking for lack of better terms, somebody who not truly invested in their craft that they could take advantage of for the moment. So I found myself, man, just being in terms of being a DJ, man, just I got to eat, man. I got a family. I got two kids, man. So, you know, I you probably DJ much better than I do. But I picked it up as a craft, something that I always loved to do when I was young, karaoke around the house. You know, I always was a bit of the life party with my family. And always was the DJ. You know, I always knew, you know, when we were going for drives or whether we had big gatherings, you know, always kind of good, had a good ear for what to play. And I just took that, man, and just kept some food in the house while I was doing the dad thing, stay-at-home dad thing, and started to find that it was actually successful. It was fruitful for me, and it was giving me the opportunity to put my music out when other people wouldn't even listen to me or give me the chance.
How did you actually go about getting into clubs and stuff like that to give you the chance to do the DJing?
Well, first, I made the investment. You know, between, man, everything's come from just my dime, man. I can't speak on how much important it is to invest in your own craft. Sometimes it'll beat you down, honestly. Like, damn, man, I may not have the money to afford this. I might have to put this on a credit, or I might have to rob Peter to pay Paul. But I found myself in those situations just having to bite the bullet to go ahead and just pursue my dream with what I really wanted. And if for that moment while I was DJing, if that was giving me an opportunity to do that, then I was just saw myself just biting the bullet, getting some peace there and building some relationships again with people that were throwing parties and giving me a good word of mouth with my DJing. And, you know, same thing with venues or just creating relationships that I can come back to. It's not like I do a show every week. I also work a 9-to-5, man, so I'm a pretty busy cat. But my last party, you know, I DJed downtown off Glenwood and Club Noir. And I've also DJed, you know, a few parties, you know, independent and private parties. And hey, you know, I'm available, you know, for that particular fun, man. And you know, it's cool for me. And again, it gives me an opportunity to play my own music and to feel the crowd and get a sense of what everybody likes to hear.
Yeah, man, I also saw that you did one of the high school reunions.
Yeah, I did, man. I did Southeast Raleigh High School reunion, man. That was actually really fun. Class of, what, 2007? 10 years. Wow, crazy. Time go by fast, man. So, yeah, you know, I have a lot of fun doing it. Again, just picking, spinning, you know, scratching a little bit, spinning the right records, getting the mixes correct, and make sure the sound's coming across so that everybody feel that beat in their soul. And so, yeah, man, I had a lot of fun with it. And the main thing is just keeping a cool head, not taking yourself too seriously at all. Even when other people do, there's owners that take themselves way too seriously at being used. There's managers, there's artists, you know, taking yourself way too seriously, man. And you can wake up one day, you're here, the next day you're gone. So ain't no use of acting like this particular platform you have right now is going to be always there for the next day when you're gone, dog. There's going to be somebody else to take over that platform. So don't take yourself so seriously. So be more humble. And that's what helped me, man, just remaining that humility, and that humility aspect is what's actually given me some opportunities.
As far as, because that's a different avenue and everything, and building your brand and stuff like that.
Absolutely.
Because that's one thing about, being in the entertainment industry and stuff like that, is, tapping in different avenues, finding your itch, because, most of the artists that's out here, the mainstream and stuff like that, they don't live off of just their music.
Right.
They don't use that as a lane to find other things to build themselves as a brand and recognize and stuff like that. Especially, you use social media and stuff like that. Companies see you, you have all these followers, they're going to reach out to you. Because mm-hmm. they're going to want to use you to tap into your followers to expand their brand or something.
Exactly.
So that's one thing, like artists, you gotta always think business-wise and stuff like that. And like, when he's looking at you came up here, jacket, shirt, it's Exposing your brain.
That's my thing, man. It's highly educated. It's my way of life.
So, what actually made you go with the phrase, I'm highly educated?
Well, man, when I was in college at UNC Pembroke, I had a good friend at the time. His name was Thurman. And I had my first song that I actually written, recorded, did the beat, and did everything to. And that song was called Highly Educated. And the hook on it was, I'm highly educated. I'm highly motivated. I'm doing my best, and Lord knows that's what these people hated. But, you know, and me and Thurman, we were taking road trips, man, and that song would come on, Thurman would find himself, you know, always kind of getting into like a trance. And he would look at me as though he was looking at me as like 10, 20 years down the road. And I was like, man, what you looking at me like that for? He was like, yo, man, that's you. That's you right there. And I'm like, Thurman, man, what the hell are you talking about, man? Like, no, man, that's you. And so when I always think about highly educated, I think about that aspect, those conversations, because what he was really saying was, I embody and encompass the message that was in that song. And, you know, I've worn that and worn that song and worn that message for the past 5 years now, since 2012 is when I officially created the brand. But the idea was actually created when I was in college. And so just actually implementing those stories and that timepiece is gave me a chance to actually, you know, wear this as a brand and articulate who I am and articulate the craft. That's why we got the brain bowl to articulate, you know, creative ideas, creative inspiration, you know, actually utilizing success in the brain and actually carrying it out tangibly through the body. And, you know, again, knowing yourself, knowing your way, and making sure you're staying highly educated out here. And it just came through that, man.
You kind of tapped into my next question, like how you came about the logo and everything.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Same scenario, man. Just what outside of the words, highly educated, would encompass and embody that, you know, a bit more. And it's just the light bulb brain, man. I had a friend that was working in California at the time. I used to live in Hollywood, California, and he was doing his he was branding, a branding expert. He eventually tapped into a lot of other things, but at the time I met him, we were doing some branding. And you know, he was one of my first guys that I was working with. His name's Reno, and Reno created my hat line, and some of the ideas that we came up with for Highly Educated were, you know, reminiscent of the brain idea. And this is one of the ones that I ended up running with, and it was just more of a defined approach in terms of what I was trying to convey to my audience. And ever since then, you know, I just continued to run with it. Shout out to the homie, you know, that helped me make a decision on what I wanted to go with. But I appreciate him for that.
Okay. So, like, what were some of your other ideas as far as like that you were picking from?
Well, there were other ideas. You know, there was you know, like a pyramid. You know, kind of like the dollar sign with the light on it. There's all, you know, all types of symbolic pyramid. All seeing eyes. What else did I have? I had stars. I had like the sky and the sun. I had like a sun with a rising sun, almost Obama-ish type stuff. And I had another brain too. I had like two or three different variations of a brain that I constructed. I actually constructed on my own. And but at the end of the day, this was the one that I pretty much was sold on in terms of moving forward with it. That's the highly educated, should know, light bulb brain right there. So.
Yeah, coming up with a logo, like, it does take some time. Like, I've been to like three different logos, and like out of the first two, like, I did myself. Something was missing. And then, like, I guess this would be like a plug to Hunger on Boulevard, where, like, they actually did my my flyers for speed dating. And so, like, they, like, I just told them what I wanted, and they basically came up with everything. I loved it. So I was like, usually I don't trust people with my ideas and stuff like that. So right. I was just like, let me go ahead and like, tell them what I want. I sent them my arm old logos, and I was like, see what you can do with this. I wanted to bring out more colors and stuff like that. And like I gave him a picture of myself and everything. So like they put me in the mask, in the quarantine mask and everything, and then they actually did another logo with me just in the headphones and stuff like that. And I just loved it for both logos and everything.
Right.
So cause, like I only wanted one, and then they were like, oh, which one do you like? I said, I like both of them, I'll pay for both of them. So like I have one for just DJ and then one for like the actual radio show and stuff like that. But like yeah, like just coming up with like that, that's your brand. That's
yeah.
The first thing that people want to see, that logo.
Yeah.
And that's like anywhere you go to, like McDonald's.
Like Golden Arch.
You see that Golden Arch, you know it's McDonald's. It's
yeah.
What recognizes you around the world and stuff
yeah.
like that.
Nike sign. Yeah.
So like they might not know your face, but they're gonna see the logo and they attach it to your name.
Exactly.
And like that's what some people don't recognize and stuff like that. As far as like on your clothing line and stuff like that, like are you working on like getting it into stores and stuff like that?
I would love to do that down the road. I would, you know, if that's as hard as I have, as the rap game has been, I'll continue to do my own thing. They can have all that shucking and jiving and trying to, you know, grease whistles in order to get you in the store. What I do, man, is I actually still set up and do my own thing, man. I got a website, IamHighlyEducated.com, where these clothes will be available for anybody that are looking for them. We got the hoodies, we'll have the shirts, we'll have the hats, and all that available there. And, you know, I don't have time for a lot of games out here with a lot of people that are still taking themselves too seriously in both of these industries. And I think where I'm at, man, is just continuing just to allow God to flow through me and allow my creativity to take its own power. So in terms of getting in somebody's store, if it ain't my store, I don't plan on getting in there. I plan on everybody going to IamHighlyEducated.com, ordering from my store, and actually, getting a highly educated brand from the actual creator, and for somebody that's actually got a bit more of a humble approach to what the consumer is looking for.
Okay. I can feel that. Like you said, like you invest in yourself and anything, you get 100% out of it and stuff like that, instead of going to the store. So yeah, and then you got the website and everything. Mm-hmm. I know personally, like that's a lot of money putting
yeah.
in the website and stuff like that.
Again, the album right now is available on IamHighlyEducated.com, Exit 300. Just go there, click on the Exit 300 symbol there, and then you can download it right now. So, again, you know, same is going to go for the clothing and apparel. It'll be right there on the site. Just click it, download it, it'll ship out to you, and we're good to go. There's no use for all this other stuff that we've got out here, at least in my opinion. Now, other people have. I've never been a person that knows everybody, but I've always been a person that knows somebody. So, I just focus on what I can control. And right now, what I can control is my own grind, my own time. And right now, IamHighlyEducated.com is where I'm going to place my shine for you to go ahead and make it happen for yourself.
And, like, as far as raising 300, like, how are you going about marketing and everything? I know you guys did a release party and everything. Like, but how are you going about promoting and marketing and reaching out to new fans and stuff like that? Because, like, right now, I can say North Carolina is real competitive right now, even though I'm going to get into that later. But how are you going about marketing?
Hey, man, I'm taking advantage of the social media lane right now. A lot of the listeners and a lot of the demographics that listen to my music are always on the phone, whether it's Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, you name it. And I'm taking advantage of that particular demographic. And, you know, I'm hitting all aspects of that up. And outside of that, I wish I could put this thing on a billboard.
It's crazy that you say that because a guy that I went to high school with, Tego B,
never heard of him.
He's real popular in like since I'm high school, he moved to Greensboro and everything. Like I was in Greensboro driving. I look up at the billboard. His face is right there, and I'm like, wow.
Awesome, right?
Yeah, like he done built up and everything. Like I when I was in high school, when I was a senior, I think it was freshman. So, but I didn't even know he did rap.
Yeah.
But like he done studied the game and everything, and he understands about branding and stuff like that. But like, yeah, it was crazy like seeing his face on the billboard.
Oh man, it is. That's something I would like to dream and see the highly educated logo up there, man. I'm actually happy for him. I'm happy he was able to.
he was able to get his face up there and you was able to see him. So did you tell him you saw his face?
No, we don't talk about that.
Okay, but you recognized him, who he was.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty cool, man. Yeah. I mean, for the same scenario in terms of marketing, there's no limits. The limitation is just wherever, you know, your pockets can take you at the moment for the time, the window of which you have to market the product. And right now with music, you know, you have a window where, you know, people are listening to it and it's hot at the moment. It's not that it can't rekindle the same, you know, steam later, but, you know, you want to place that in something that is hot right now. And right now I'm placing that into, you know, the mainstream of social media and placing that into clothing. And actually, in terms of Raleigh, just stepped out a lot more than what I normally have. Again, this is probably like my third or fourth interview since I've dropped the album. And just stepping out a bit more and being seen a bit more. And a lot of my barber has actually told me that I need to tell my story. When I get the chance to actually tell my story, he actually feels that more people will follow. So basically, man, just my marketing is just actually really doing that, telling my story, embracing my culture. And allowing people to grasp that off learning the true nature of who I am.
Okay. I can feel that. As far as North Carolina as a whole, last week was the first time I actually talked to somebody that was actually nominated. First time I talked to somebody that was nominated and won the Carolina Music Award.
Congratulations.
So, is that something that you want to try to steer to? Is being nominated for one of the Carolina Music Awards? Or, like, how do you actually see the Carolina scene and everything as far as how they grow with that actual award show?
Man, listen. I would be surprised if I was ever nominated for anything. I ain't ever won nothing. Like, especially not no Carolina Music Awards. I would be surprised if even that sector of people even thought enough to nominate me for something. But that's you know, I really would be surprised because, you know, I've tried to deal with a lot of people, man, that try to set themselves apart, wanting to do things for people like myself that have a budget, that have a plan, that know where they want to go, and then I'll reach out to them, and then it's nothing. And so, you know, for me to, you know, again, get to the point to where I feel like I want to be praised by a particular group of people, I'm so far past that, but I can give a damn about a Carolina Music Award, man. I just want y'all to vote with y'all dollar. I want y'all to vote with y'all time. If I end up getting nominated for an award, that's great. And I think I would really appreciate it because it would all come to a surprise for me and all straight up. But, you know, I don't expect people out here or people. That's just the name. It's not to put my city down, but it's just from what I've seen. I've been doing this for over 10 years, well over it. And although certain people have progressed, there's certain behaviors in the industry that hasn't, and certain behaviors in the town that hasn't, you know, and that's very unfortunate. And in terms of, you know, awards, you know, sometimes that's the same scenario, just hasn't progressed. Some of the talent that's really out here goes unnoticed over and over and over again, and it's just unfortunate. And if I was actually noticed for what I actually did out here, man, that mean God really is smiling on me more than I even think sometimes.
That's another thing I was about to ask you about the artists in the city and stuff like that. And, like, do you feel like you see a lot of collaboration, or do you see, like, a lot of people that come on the show, they say this about North Carolina, is that it's basically like crabs in a bucket. Everybody trying to get over or next one. And, like, that's why we have to, like I said, I've been saying this since I had the show. Like, there's a lot of talent in North Carolina.
It is.
And, like, there's no reason that we can't make a mark like Atlanta or Houston.
Houston, definitely, right? Wouldn't that be beautiful?
So, like,
I heard a Houston track with 40 rappers on it. 40 rappers got to eat, whether they were BMI, ASCAP, whatever they ate, they got to eat. And they were with national recording artists like Slim Thug, Pimp C, Chamillionaire, Paul Wall, you name it. Where the beef at, dog? Why we got to have such animosity against each other? Or why we got to, I'm gonna be there and don't show up? Why we gotta do that? I don't know. Maybe because the nature of the artists that are here aren't mature enough. Maybe because they're stuck in their ego. Maybe because they're not humble enough. Maybe because they take themselves too seriously. Maybe because they don't. I mean, it's a lot of different reasons. But until, you know, you I don't really worry too much about that, because I've seen it, I've been involved in it, and man, I'm looking forward. I'm not worried about none of that. Anybody who wants to work with me, they're working with me because they with me. What, like I said earlier, I don't work with anybody that's coming with a lot of what I'm used to and accustomed to out here. I've seen it, I know what you're coming with, and I can spot it miles away. And so, but nowadays, man, I love working with artists and collabing with artists that, you know, I can pick their brains and pick their ideas, and they can do the same for mine. And it's a mutual love and a mutual respect with where we're going. And I like it when I can actually teach and people are actually there to listen and learn. And I also like to actually follow people that actually are giving themselves up for me to be a student. And so, you know, I look for that, man. I look for people that I can judge by the content of their character. That's it, man. Like, you may be a great artist, but you may be a terrible businessman. You may be a great artist, but you may be a terrible father. You may be a great artist, but you may be a terrible husband, a terrible son. On and on and on. If all you got that's great about you is rap, then you need to put rap down, separate that, and clean up the rest of your life. And I think a lot of people out here in Raleigh, in terms of that, and not even just in Raleigh, just general in rappers, man, singers, we have to get out and realize sometimes we got to clean up who we are as a person before our actual craft comes along in terms of as a true jewel to somebody else. So I think a lot of that is just maturity, guys. Like, in terms of chill out, y'all ain't the hottest thing in the world. Even if you was, that don't mean that we all secure the bag here. Until one of us really secure the bag, we all still together in this lane. So there should be more of a support for one another. There shouldn't be everything, but that's just what we got here. And you have to maneuver your way through the BS sometimes in order to find the roses.
True, true. And it's like, it's crazy. Like, it's nothing that we mentioned is that most of the artists that actually get out of North Carolina are from North Carolina. Like, they wild out of North Carolina.
Nah,
like,
I mean,
J. Cole, he was up in New York.
He was in New York.
I honestly don't know the backstory about Petey Pablo, but he actually did come.
He wasn't in North Carolina, I'll tell you that.
Like, he came back and everything. Like, I remember when I first saw the Raised Up video, I forgot where I was, but like,
he was on Jive Records at the time when he dropped it out.
And I remember watching the video on, I was in Greensboro, and I remember watching the video, like, yo, it's raw, man. Like, yeah. I know that area and stuff like that. Like, he brought it back and everything. I saw people that knew in the video and stuff like that. He actually brought it back, but at the same time, like, I don't know if he didn't sit there to bring artists with him and stuff like that.
Yeah. And then part of that was in it's not, if it's not in a person's character to do that, then it's not his responsibility. And I don't want to put that on that man, because one of the things that he did do is he shed a national light on our culture here and on our city here, and I greatly appreciate him for that. And you know, he did open the lane for some rappers to come through. I remember there was a rapper he was working with back, Balboa or something like that, back in the day. It was a couple of rappers he actually worked with. Here he's working with now. I mean, I've heard stuff with Mr. Raleigh and C. I've heard stuff with like a lot of different rappers from here to where he's actually just done things with in order to just provide them a platform to say they've worked with a national recording artist. But you know, in terms of us as a culture here doing more about what we have here, we could just do more. We could realize that we have a platform. We actually have eyes. Raleigh is a place where nationally people want to come and want to grow and expand. I mean, to be honest with you, I'm an anomaly in Raleigh. When people realize I'm born and raised in Raleigh, North Carolina, they're like, what? I've never met anybody born and raised from Raleigh. So we gotta realize what we have and actually having a culture here and being able to sustain it and not allow people to come and hijack it and then at some point make it theirs. Because if we don't, if we continue to have this crab in a barrel method and everything like that, that's what'll happen. Somebody right, not even from here, will come exploit the area and benefit the proceeds from all the people and all the culture that is rich here. So it's going to take us to truly come together on this.
Yeah, and I want to knock nobody down or anything and stuff like that, but like, I know like some artists that I've talked to, and like talented, very talented, and they just wanted to collab with some artists, and like,
they told me like this artist just said that it's $1,000 for a feature, $800 for a feature. And I'm like, who do they think they are to be charging that much for a feature? Like we all, like I said, we all from North Carolina. We should be just trying to collab. Like you said, like Houston had that one track. Like I'm trying to remember that track.
Oh man, Houston has so many tracks, bro. That so many artists were on. One of my favorite tracks is Slim Thug Still Breaking Boys Off, though. That's my jam. Still Breaking Boys Off.
I think it was on that they sampled Why Am I Jody?
Okay, yeah.
You remember, you know,
yeah, the one with Bun B, yeah. 8 Ball MJG, had David Banner, had a couple different people on there. Rick
then,
Ross.
And then, I mentioned this on the last track, last show too, about Atlanta, like you had. Ludacris and T.I. beefing, and like you had the Atlanta people coming together trying to make them squash that beef and stuff like that.
Because
you
it was about the culture.
Yeah, and then you have so many documentary on Atlanta and stuff like that. Like I even watched the Dungeon Family documentary and stuff like that. Like I didn't even realize how much they had with the culture.
Legendary.
And I thought it was amazing, like how they came up with the
Dungeon Family, Organized Noise,
TLC track.
Mm-hmm.
Don't Go Chasing Waterfalls. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen that documentary?
I haven't seen the documentary, but I'm familiar with the work.
Yeah.
I'm very heavily inspired by Dungeon Family work, UGK, Outkast. I'm heavily inspired by those two big time.
So like it was just like so what like I love watching hip hop documentaries. So I need to watch that one, the Dr. Dre one. I forgot what it's because it's on HBO.
Okay.
I believe. They talk about I forgot what the name
was. Is it Dr. Dre one for real? I gotta check this one out.
Yeah, because I know they also talking about how he met Eminem and stuff like that on there as well.
Okay.
But yeah, I need to watch that as well. But I just like watching. Documentaries, just people upbringing. This is the music industry is just an avenue.
Mm-hmm.
It's an avenue. Like you see people like Snoop, like he's global.
Yeah.
You think about where he started at, Jenny Juice.
Yeah. He's in your living room. My kids know Snoop Dogg.
And you think about Ice T.
Same scenario. And Ice Cube.
About after Police.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's playing the police now.
Yeah.
So. It's just an avenue, and like they take advantage of it, mm-hmm. and everything. It's about they understood the business mind of it. Like these were people from the hood, and like they were able to develop and understand the business side of it. Jay-Z, like I tell people, like Jay-Z is not my number one. I'm not the number one fan of Jay-Z lyrically, but business wise.
Oh yeah.
Like the way that he was able to evolve.
You have to admire that. Absolutely.
And then like his last album, he came for knowledge.
Yeah. It took him about 30 albums, but man, regardless, we appreciate it.
Yeah. But that album, like when I listened to it and everything, like the only reason I got it, I just like Sprint had that title.
Gotcha.
Promotion.
Gotcha.
I got title. Got
hey, you know what? AZ 300 is available on Tidal too, so make sure you get that.
That's
stream that. I am. AZ 300 is on Tidal, on Spotify. Stream that, download that, whatever you got to do. But Book T, AZ 300.
Yeah, I'm gonna make sure. Because we wrap up at the end. How is it with you? Have you actually seen the stream revenue or something like that?
Have I seen stream revenue? Oh yeah, I've been getting revenue from streams and for downloads and for residuals for quite some time now. I've been, since at least 2006. So over 10 years, just been doing various work, whether it was a beat here, whether it was a song. Because you're right, music provides a lane and an avenue. It's not always, I won't even really call myself a rapper as much as just an all-out entertainer or just creative talent. Because I've gotten money off just doing beats. If I have Xbox beats or, Nick Nortel at one point was playing some stuff or Metro PCS. And I would find myself on radio commercials or my stuff on
internet sites, you know, digital web platforms, and from all that, you know, I would draw a residual from that. And, you know, that's just all, man, it didn't cost me anything to withdraw a residual. It just cost me time and effort in terms of doing the paperwork and making sure I was abreast of the details to how to draw back the money. But, you know, outside of the paperwork and actually putting forth the effort to create the music, that's all the win for me. So you think most artists got to get out of the idea of seeing themselves as just an artist, like thinking, yo, I'm just going to drop this hot 16 and I'm going to be the hottest dude on the block. That's just not, it's not even logical anymore. Like, nobody's just going to realize, like, yo, I was in Raleigh one day and I was on the corner stopping by Snoopy's for a hot dog, son. And I heard Shorty spitting the 16 and I was like, son, it blew my mind. It's the next Biggie. Like, that's not going to happen, man. Like, I mean, even if it did, great for who that was, but that is one in a million, brothers. Like, you might as well buy a lottery ticket. So the main thing is that, you know, if you really want to put it in perspective, you got to start taking yourself seriously, craft yourself like Jay-Z did, like as an actual business. If you can, everything we're doing, and I tell artists that I mentor this all the time, if you turn yourself into the business, you'll find that everything you're doing to invest in yourself is not only expanding your knowledge and expanding, you know, your craft and you're building a brand, but in terms of you getting residuals, you're getting the money off whatever you're working on, and this is also tax deductible. This is also stuff you claim on your taxes in terms of the trips you might have made and things you might have invested in terms of the expenses you had in order to book this building so that I can make XX money. Like, whatever, man, all that stuff is a business. And just like a business pays for overhead, you have to pay for overhead in order to promote yourself and get yourself out here. So it takes you just putting on a smarter cap than the cap that's just, I rolled a 16, I think I'm gonna be the next Migos or something like that, the next Gucci man. Like, you gotta just be smarter than that.
One thing that I've been trying to get people to tell me and everything, but they don't really want to touch on that. Like, I heard that title, you make the most money off of. Like, what's the difference between the streaming platform as far as your residual?
The money comes later when it's residual. A lot of times the money comes on a quarter basis. So it's the same can happen with your streaming platforms too. But for the most part, you'll get your residual income every 2 to 4 quarters, depending on who you're with, what company you're with. And basically, your residuals come off of radio plays or public plays of your music. And the actual streaming platform comes from the actual streams of that particular platform. So you can make a lot more money a lot of times with streams up front than you can on the back end of a residual, because I could have a heavy streaming month this month, but a low streaming month next month, and I made a lot of streaming money this month, but a low residual for the quarter. Does that make sense? So it's important to make sure that you're allocating in both of them, because they're both revenue streams for you. And you know, at the end of the day, residual income is something that it is what it is. So you're always going to be able to make money off that as long as it's in rotation. And as long as, you know, you are in charge of it, or at least willed it to another family member, friend, or whatever, but it'll always be there for you.
Okay. Well, we're coming up at the end of the show and everything. Is there anything that we haven't touched on that you want people to know about you and about your social media platforms and everything?
Anything I want the people to know about me? Let's see. Everybody, I feel like everybody knows a lot, man. I rep L.A. Hall, L.A. Lakers. I'm a Laker fan. I'm a Panther fan all day long as far as my sports teams. Yeah, man. I rep the Heels in college. You know, I'm a sports man. I'm a sports fanatic. Before hip-hop and rap, you know, I thought I was going to be a sportscaster. So, and shout-out to a lot of my friends that I graduated with in Pembroke, man, that ended up actually making it to ESPN. And living out their dreams. Jeff, Jimmy, Melina, you know, a lot of them, man. Even names I've forgotten, man. I'm very proud of them. But things that people don't know about me. It's probably that how big of a sports fan I am and how much of an analyst I am and how much I also appreciate people first. I try not to look at people as celebrities or being bigger than what they are, because we're all, you know, spirits first, just living in vessels here, making the human decisions, and none of us are perfect. And so, you know, that's another thing is that, you know, you might want me to look at you like you the man, dog, but you might see me and might realize, why you not looking at me like I'm the man? I'm like, dog, you're just another person. So don't, if anybody feels that, don't be alarmed. I see people as people. I see who you are, and I judge you by the content of your character. So that's who I am. And as far as my social media platforms, IamHollyEducated.com is my website, personal website for downloads, bios, pictures, you know, you name it. Make sure you come back there and go to there, IamHollyEducated.com. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, follow me at IamBookT. Again, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, doesn't matter, man. It's at IamBookT. The same on YouTube, IamBookT. You'll be able to find a list of videos and music to listen to. Same for SoundCloud, IamBookT. So when you want to follow me, you just got to realize who you are. And if you're a little bit of BookT, you're a little bit of me, just go to IamBookT.
Appreciate you coming back on the show, chopping up, keeping us updated on what's going on with you and stuff like that. We got to bring you back on the show to talk sports, because like I completely forgot I got carried away with everything we were talking about. Yeah, I heard those little slide stuff.
Man, you got some changes to make, man.
But like I said, I gotta go big. I can't go another year with James talking about. Like, he tried to put me out.
James trying to drop the big Hogan leg on you, dog. That's another thing. I'm a wrestling fanatic, too, man.
Every year that I have that, every time I come on WrestleMania.
Oh, man, I love it.
So we might want to bring you on one day, because I try to have that WrestleMania on the special as well. So.
I am here. I will give you full analysis. But I tell you, I'm there. So let me know.
We just had that fast pay-per-view.
What? That was crazy, right?
Yeah.
How he came back.
Yeah, and I appreciate that we got to wrap up. I appreciate everybody that tune in, whatever platform that you're on. But make sure you go on Spreaker.com and actually hit that follow button. Hit that follow button on Spreaker.com. And I see the listeners and everything, but after you listen, make sure you hit that follow button and stuff like that. Like I said, I just got on Quarantine Enterprise where you have the live, and like I actually unintentionally heard it, that it actually does work, that you can actually listen to the live thing on there. I was hearing an echo, and I was like, what's going on? And I realized that my browser was actually on QuarantineEnterprise.com. But other than that.
One more thing. The album release party this Saturday, October 28th, at Motions Lounge. Make sure you're in the building. Starts at 10, $10 to get in, $20 for VIP. We got a lot of merchandise, CDs there for everybody to take part in. And I'm actually going to perform some tracks, so make sure you're in the building. That's it, man.
All right. So, Motion Lounge, Saturday night, 10 o'clock. Make sure you're there. What's the address?
Oh, man, I got to pull that up. I don't remember addresses. Addresses and phone numbers. It's 2017. It's by the Red Lobster on Wake Forest Road.
So, other than that, stay tuned. Thursday we actually have Akilah Faye poet coming through and everything. I'm actually booked up until December with interviews.
That's good. Yeah. That's fantastic.
And I'm trying to put a hold on it because I hate, cause like that's one thing that I used to hate in the past is that I'd be booked up too far in advance and then some people forget and stuff like that. But December, that's something, if you've been noticing on Facebook, I'm trying to wrap everything up. If you notice something on Facebook, I've been asking relationship questions. We're trying to bring back the Does Love Exist in This Era panel and everything. Like I've had three in the past. I'm trying to bring a new panel up, talk about it and everything. If you're married, single, just got out of a heartbreak and everything, you're interested in coming up here and talking about love in this era and stuff like that, hit me up info@quarantineenterprise.com. Let me know. We're trying to have that panel in December. So if you're interested in coming on the panel, just talking about love and stuff like that. I'm trying to have it in December. I had a whole bunch of people hit me up. But it's funny, I had a whole bunch of girls this time. Because back in the past, if you actually listen to the past, like the panel was full of guys. So I'm really intrigued that we had a bunch of girls interested in being on this panel this time. But yeah, I am filled up until December. December, most likely, like first 2 weeks, I'm going to try to have the But other than that, I appreciate everybody listening. Like I said, make sure you follow on Spreaker. I just got the Twitter, quarantine_ it's just Quarantine Radio on Twitter. Ill_McKenzie on Twitter, Instagram and stuff like that. Follow this show as well, Quarantine. Once again, I appreciate Book T. Make sure you come out Saturday night. Check him out. This show as well, Quarantine. We'll see you Thursday.
Hey, this is Nola Otto, and you are now rocking the Ill McKenzie right here.
Boy Gabe, but I want to give a big shout out to Quarantine Radio. Make sure you check them out every Tuesday and every Thursday. And thank you for supporting my new single, Down Low.
Yo, what's up, man? It's the Kid Swiffer, baby. Young Swift. One time for the check-in with my dog, my homie, Ill McKenzie. Straight out of ATL, Georgia. And you know how we rocking out here, baby. Let's get it.
Humble, humble get no respect.